Mr. Chairman, as we start the 17th session, we should pause and commend the progress achieved in the implementation of the CWC. And I would like to mention mainly, firstly, the successful destruction of 75% of the total declared stockpiles of chemical weapons, and a particular appreciation to the progress made by Libya, Iraq, the United States of America, and the Russian Federation in their endeavors to destroy all their stockpiles. Worth mentioning also is the plan developed by Japan to destroy the weapons abandoned in China. Considering the undertakings of the states' parties to CWC, we call upon the relevant states to adhere to the deadlines for the destruction of chemical weapons, and this will increase the credibility of the CWC. We also call for strengthening international cooperation and exchange of knowledge in the field of use of chemistry for peaceful purposes and other non-prohibited purposes under the CWC, as we aim to attain the objectives of the CWC. Secondly, the near universality of the CWC, which is conducive to achieving the goals and contributing to international peace and security. The membership now stands at 188. Very few countries remain outside its remit. It is thus the fast-growing convention in a very short time after entry into force. It is therefore important that efforts should be made to convince the remaining states to join our family. It is worth noting that the efforts made to create a zone free of weapons of mass destruction in the Middle East failed. We are disappointed for that, and we call upon the parties to organize that meeting as soon as possible in 2013. Thirdly, the signing of the supplementary arrangements to the relationship agreement with the United Nations provides for the cooperation between the organization and the United Nations in case of alleged use of chemical weapons in a non-state party or the threat of use in an area not under the direction of a state party, and this should be under the auspices of the United Nations. This gives the OPCW a role to play in international security. Mr. Chairman, the United Arab Emirates has, under the supervision of its national authority, has implemented its internal regime in relation to chemicals and has developed a model certificate for imports and exports. This has enabled us to facilitate our declarations and to submit them in electronic format by using the EDNA system adopted by the OPCW. We have also finalized work of internal regulations and legislation, and we will cooperate with DTS in view of their final adoption. Our national authority participated in the 10th regional meeting of the national authorities in Asia held in Sri Lanka last June. That meeting was an opportunity for national authorities of the region to cooperate to support the CWC in its universality and improve its implementation. Mr. Chairman, we are in the preparatory stages for the third review conference next year, and we would like to thank Her Excellency Nassima Baghli of Algeria, the chairperson of the open-ended working group on the review conference, for her efforts, and we support the efforts of the opening group in order to achieve the goals of the third review conference. Finally, we hope, Mr. Chairman, that our deliberations will contribute to achieving more progress in the implementation of the CWC, and I would call to circulate this document as an official document of this session. Thank you.